To be an issue. Pebble Beach is actually much shorter than recent U.S. Open venues, which may, at his age, play into the hands of Tiger Woods. So technically, you don't need to drive the ball a mile to win here. So we'll see. More from Drea right now.
Right now is one over. In a time where big hitters dominate the golf world, driving the ball further than we have ever seen, this year's U.S. Open at Pebble Beach requires a certain finesse, testing the touch of the game's top players.
Pebble is almost laughably short for a championship golf course in this modern era. The game has changed so much and Pebble's remain the same. That's part of its charm.
Pebble Beach is the shortest U.S. Open course played in the last 6 years. Here, it's not necessarily about how far you hit the ball, but how it soars.
What makes Pebble so interesting is that it's an old-style golf course that really makes you control your golf ball.
Pebble Beach, of course, known for those beautiful views of the ocean, but it's not just for looking at. It gives this course a really unique feel. Many of the holes are set up on this slope, pulling the fairways down towards the coastline.
People that can actually control their golf ball are going to do the best out of from day to day in each round.
Now, of course, the tour's heavy hitters could still be dangerous here at Pebble Beach, but the dimensions of this course are also inviting to a wider field, sort of opening up the competition.
It's a more democratic kind of golf course. It's going to be more about positioning off the tee and then being really precise into those tiny greens, and of course you got to make the putts.
We have seen all types of scores here at Pebble Beach. Tiger Woods historically winning back in 2000, shooting 12 under. But then Graham McDowell won the U.S. Open in 2010 with even par. So anything can happen on the Central Coast.